ocean.
He's scared. He wants to go back.
The vast blue sea has always fascinated me. But it also scares me a lot. Because I've never stepped foot in water. I don't know how to swim. But I'm going to be doing something that I never dreamt of doing before. I am going to scuba dive.
So scared, but the entire time I'm like, Neha, you should do it.
Join me on this journey to discover if a non-swimmer can scuba dive or not.
Yeah, we're going scuba diving.
She's shit scared, huh?
After enrolling ourselves in a dive shop and gearing up, we had an amazingly convincing chat with our dive instructor.
And the most important question that I don't know swimming and I'm shit scared.
You don't need to know swimming. We're not swimming, we're diving. We're going underwater. Swimming is on the surface.
But nothing, I mean, like, I don't know.
So you don't need to swim then? If you're scared of water.
Yeah. I'm not like, I've never done anything in water, no? So that's why I'm just having this little initial fear.
That's okay. You know, that's quite obvious. And if you've never gone in the water, then you're going to be anxious.
All I've done is like put my feet in water.
So here the important thing is to remember of what's the biggest thing. Why do people get scared of water? Because when you go underwater, you can't breathe.
Right.
Yeah. Now you've got a whole tank of it.
Right.
So that's.
So I have no breathing issues.
Can you breathe from your mouth? Can you drink juice with a straw? Can you blow out a candle with your mouth? Yes. That's all we need.
So then,
given the fact that you're comfortable, but every time saying I want to come up. Anything, it takes us about 20 to 25 minutes to cover the
water.
We've got a system in, there's a gauge, so everything is monitored. We're monitoring how much you breathe. You can't lie to us underwater because we can see the bubbles. So
yeah,
if you're saying, if you're not relaxed, we will know.
Okay.
Because your safety is more important than...
Yeah. Don't go with the negative mindset. Everything underwater, because it's a new environment, you're on a life support system, basically. Try and relax. You have to trust the gear and you have to trust us.
I can't see far.
Everything is enlarged by 33% of water. So up to minus 3 and it's all right. It automatically water itself enlarges it. So you can see properly up to minus 3.
So I'll chuckle it.
Now, if you overthink it, your mind will start asking too many questions, blah blah blah.
Everything is really, really, we slow everything down underwater. Alright? So you have more time to look at things, observe things. If you like something, point it out and say, I want to go there, we'll take you closer to it. No catching anything, no trying to chase anything, no touching anything.
Okay? These are alive. Tell him.
Everything is alive, yeah.
We then head out towards the shore to understand the basics of diving.
Just follow instructions. We've been doing this quite often for a couple of years now. So we know what we're doing in general. Everyone is different, every personality is different. That's why we do the training for you guys.
What has he told you not to do?
Touch anything.
Don't touch anything.
It was then a beautiful boat ride to the dive spot.
The sky is so far.
And then arrived the moment of truth. Was I finally going to scuba dive or not? After me, it was Arindam. Being the adventure junkie he is, he was like a fish in the sea.
scuba diving, and it was the most beautiful experience ever. I am a non-swimmer. I know nothing about swimming, but I just realized that scuba diving actually doesn't involve swimming at all. And deep down in the sea, it is so beautiful. You see so many fish, schools of fish, so many other coral reefs, beautiful coral reefs and other sea creatures. And there's so many of them in the Neel Island. If you're coming to Andamans, and you can't leave without scuba diving.